He's a sucker. He's got guns and he's got semen coated VHS tapes.
Pastor Tommy Evans has made an astounding accusation against his fellow preacher, T.D. Jakes, in a dramatic and unexpected development that has shocked the evangelical community. He claims the respected leader of the Potter's House has been involved in coercing male churchgoers into having one-night stands with him. This shocking disclosure was made in an open discussion with a well-known religious journal. The topic of conversation unexpectedly shifted from Evans' personal moral shortcomings and the affair that caused him to leave the church to his colleague T.D. Jakes. Evans did this in an unguarded moment of candor. According to Pastor Evans, T.D. Jakes' crimes were far more serious than his deeds, even though they may have been morally dubious. He said that Jakes had engaged in a string of extramarital romances with several congregants, abusing his position of power to control and take advantage of weaker people. There are also rumors that a young man has hired an attorney to defend him in a lawsuit against Jakes over an incident.
It's also been said that a young male has acquired a lawyer to represent him as he is set to sue Jakes for an incident that took place when he was just years old. It's been said that the young man was forced to perform sloppy toppy, and I'm paraphrasing here, guys. You can actually put two and two together to understand what I'm trying to say. It's been said that the man's family were members of the Potter's House but left the church in 2015.
The explosive magnitude of the statements and the significant ramifications for their spiritual leaders left the followers of both pastors stunned and unsettled in their faith. The disclosure triggered a wave of acute scrutiny and criticism, in addition to casting a lengthy, dark shade over Jake's previously spotless reputation as a revered spiritual leader and mentor. This extraordinary revelation caused many to seriously doubt his morality and integrity, undermining the trust and respect that had long been attached to his name. After the incident, followers examined themselves introspectively and struggled with feelings of betrayal and disillusionment as they faced the uncomfortable truth of their desire. Admired leaders were accused of wrongdoing. Following Evans' shocking accusations, T.D. Jakes chose to say nothing, purposefully avoiding responding to the claims in public. This decision to remain silent simply helped to fuel the rumors and conjecture that surrounding the incident. As a result, opinions and theories diverged across a range of platforms, causing the public to become sharply divided over the veracity of Evans' accusations. I come not to persuade you or anyone else. I am confident in who I am. I arrived to hear the master congratulate his well-behaved and obedient worker. Some people and organizations vehemently demanded an open and exhaustive investigation into Jake's behavior, contending that an exhaustive assessment was required to ascertain the truth and guarantee responsibility. They felt that this kind of investigation would shed light and possibly, on the basis of hard data, exonerate or imprison the accused. However, a number of people maintained their skepticism and wondered if the accusations were just a calculated attempt to divert attention from other problems or a calculated diversion.
Tony Evans, who wrote a book on fatherhood.
He's written a lot of books.
Yeah, and big church.
For a long time.
Kingdom Man. I mean, for years, I've listened to Tony Evans preach. The first time I heard him was on Focus on the Family, and he was just talking about being a great husband and a father, and this guy is just money.
Even though he was a great husband and father, the interview, which took place at Pastor Evans' house soon after he resigned from Oak Cliff Bible Fellowship, also covered his recent struggles and hardships on a personal level. It is important to keep in mind the recent controversy surrounding the allegations that Evans had an affair with his wife behind closed doors and then received death threats from a church member. There are now grave worries for Pastor Evans' safety and well-being due to the threats, which were made via email, social media, and even the mail. Although no arrests have been made thus far, law enforcement officials have been informed of the threats and are presently looking into them. Pastor Evans made a public statement to address the scandal, admitting his moral shortcomings and pleading with his family, congregation, and the community at large for forgiveness. He insisted that the relationship was consensual and refuted any compulsion or manipulation in it.
That now he needed to step away
and to resign to get himself together and to be a worshiper in the church. I don't think it was necessary for him to do that unless there was potential video footage that might pop up in the near future. What y'all think about the situation?
Attendance at Oak Cliff Bible Fellowship has plummeted, with many congregants expressing their disappointment and anger over the betrayal. Several church leaders have called for Pastor Evans' immediate resignation, while others have urged the congregation to pray for healing and reconciliation. Critics claim that Pastor Evans' actions represent a wider problem of misuse of authority among religious leaders. This is not a unique event, said Dr. Sarah Thompson, a theologian and expert on church ethics. We need to address the systemic factors that allow such actions to go undetected. Weeks ago, T.D. Jakes, accused of having been involved in organizing prostitution at the megachurch, stunning believers and non-believers, raising eyebrows about what can possibly happen more in this shit gospel realm. It's revealed that there's a network of concealed passages and hidden chambers of illicit activities allegedly orchestrated by T.D. Jakes within the church premises. Cops stormed through the Potter's house and uncovered secret chambers equipped with hidden cameras and microphones, where vulnerable and sexually addicted individuals were persuaded into engaging in acts of prostitution under the guise of spiritual assistance and counseling. I couldn't believe what I found. One cop confessed, his voice expressing a mix of regret and bewilderment. Secret chambers with cameras and microphones, and all those men defenseless and lost, taught to believe their salvation lay in deeds no soul should endure.
He had every room taped and bugged, and they found little bugs and little tape recorders. I mean, those micro projectors or whatever like that, or video cameras. They found them in the house, bro. So by them having those things in the house, and people know there's drugs, there's alcohol.
The charge against T.D. Jakes created a terrifying picture of abuse cloaked as spiritual counsel, where promises of divine intervention were tools of manipulation. Tedman described the heart-wrenching testimony of men forced into behaviors far apart from the sanctuary's hallowed beliefs. Each discovery seemed like a blade through the heart of a community that had trusted T.D. Jakes as a beacon of unshakable faith. In reaction to the charges, T.D. Jakes, known internationally for his inspiring teachings and spiritual assistance, angrily disputed the accusations. He remained steadfast in the face of intense public scrutiny and denounced the allegations as malicious lies meant to ruin his reputation and undo years of devoted service. His legal team got to work right once, requesting retractions and getting ready for a trial that would decide not just what would happen to his reputation, but also what would happen to the Potter's house in the future. The previously sacred corridors of the Potter's home were shrouded in mystery as officials began a comprehensive inquiry into Tubman's charges as the wheels of justice churned.
The Lord said that Bishop T.D. Jakes will have one of the biggest scandals of all time in the Christian church, one of the biggest shaming falls before God finally judges him in taking his life. His scandal will involve his sexual orientation, and God says that this is when people will finally see who they have been following with a lot of these pastors and spiritual leaders.
There are also rumors that T.D. Jakes has been subtly setting up freak-offs at his Texas estate. Sources close to Tubman claim that he unintentionally revealed during a private luncheon that T.D. Jakes has been throwing lavish parties known as freak-offs, where powerful people partake in strange activities with Jakes' entourage. In a recent video, Manasseh Jordan, one of the preacher's former mentees, revealed that victims of the reputed power bottom, Bishop, are getting ready to sue him. This might mean that the preacher will soon be facing accusations in court. As a result, additional victims have come forward, and Manasseh Jordan, a former student of Bishop T.D. Jakes who asserted that the pastor mentored him, has spoken with them. Manasseh alleges that two victims he spoke with and Bishop T.D. Jakes allegedly groomed and assayed him. Someone said, "I think Manasseh would have sobbed if he had said anything else. He was that close, And in spite of his denials, I think he was either a victim or very nearly was sad. One participant, more focused on the others standing with the alleged attacker, remarked, "I have personally seen and experienced this. His collapse gave me shivers. The enchantment that leads devotees to revere these men and women as gods must be broken."
One of the things that really happens and seldom talked about is that there's something called grooming. And it happens in the Pentecostal church, it happens in many churches, but I'm referring to the Black church specifically.
Scandal had immediate effects. The attendance at the churches where both pastors served saw a decrease. Followers found it difficult to reconcile the troubling nature of the claims with their admiration for the individuals they had once revered. A problematic aspect of power and influence inside the church was revealed by the impact from the discoveries, which led many people to reassess their opinions of spiritual leadership. Pastor Evans maintained his position, saying that Jakes needed to face consequences and that he had spoken the truth in spite of the backlash and the media's shifting attention. The evangelical community remained split, with some expressing doubt and unbelief and others supporting Evans. The allegations' fallout rippled across the community, casting a long shadow over the faith and leadership that were previously seen as cornerstones of moral and spiritual direction, even as the crisis subsided and the press stopped mentioning it. In any case, we sincerely hope you liked viewing this film, and that we may all continue to. In any case, we sincerely hope you liked seeing this movie and that you will all keep trying to please God.